Now, the great thing about the Aussie jungle are the unlikely friendships that have been forming, as well as the incredible conversations happening in camp.
Yeah, a four-time Olympic swimmer, Emily Seebohm, and new pal David have bonded both on and off the screen of the hit TV show. And Emily and David join us now from Brisbane. Hello, guys.
Good morning.
Morning. Oh,
it has been such a brilliant show to watch both of you in action. The David, we might start with you. You originally entered camp as a fake celebrity. That meant you had to do a little bit of fibbing there. How did it feel to be living out a lie?
I was a fraudster. It was honestly the funniest thing I have ever done. Everybody believed me. All the celebs believed everything I said. Bo was a bit of a struggle, but it was a piece of cake.
Just goes to show how gullible we are.
Yeah, everyone's so gullible.
Well, no, it was a fantastic twist because we were warned about a twist coming up in it. And I guess with shows like this, you don't know what to expect. Everyone thinks that I know every single person in Ireland as well. Celebrities don't work that way as well. Emily, you spent a bit of time with David, obviously, in camp. Did you have any idea that he was fibbing? And how would you describe your friendship now? You guys seem pretty close.
It's funny, we clicked the very first day that I got in. I was in the second group, David was in the first group. So as soon as we met each other, we kind of clicked. We had a few similarities and we lived really close by. And yeah, I had no idea he wasn't a celebrity. I just believed everything he told me. And in the end, I was kind of like, how did you get that past me? Like, how did you not slip it up at all? I was so confused. I was a little bit hurt because I was like, but we had a really strong friendship. I actually felt a little bit hurt.
I call it method acting.
So David, were the relationships real? Are you actually friends with Emily?
Yeah. She's been teaching me TikTok and, yeah.
No, we've had a right laugh since we got off the show.
Yeah.
So David, if you're not a celebrity, what do you do in your normal day-to-day life?
So I usually just do marketing and events. So super chill, not celebrity.
Awesome. Well, you are now.
Yeah. No. Yeah, I'm still waiting for my blue tick.
I reckon you should put a shoe out anyway, just for the novelty of it. Maybe that's the way forward. Emily, you've been incredibly open during your time in the jungle, particularly about your candid experience as a four-time Olympian. Whether it's the pressure Australians put on our Olympians or highlighting the surprisingly low pay of our athletes, which just blew my mind. Is there anything about the treatment of Olympians that you would like to see change?
I think every sport and every culture, there's always room to change and there's always room to grow. I think as this world is opening up and we're living more of it, we can see that there are things that we used to do in the past that we can't do now that aren't appropriate. And I think, you know, we just need to continue that change and continue growing and continue learning. I think we can always learn something every day. So why can't the sports grow and change with us?
Emily, you've also opened up about some personal struggles, some really personal struggles that you've had with an eating disorder, and there's no denying the positive impact from a conversation that this can have on people. Were you aware of the impact that you were having just by sharing your own lived experience?
I guess for me, it was very hard for me to open up to the campmates because I've never done that before to a group of people. I've told my mum and dad and a couple of my friends, but I've never actually said those words to a group of people or to a camera before. So I was very nervous about that conversation. But going into the jungle, I wanted to be open. I wanted to be honest. I wanted to share my experiences because I've just realised in the time that I've done that, the amount of people that have come to me and said, oh, my God, thank you so much for opening up. It really means a lot to me. I feel the same sort of way. And I think that's the special part. That's why I do it. That's why, you know, we go on these shows for our charities and to open up and to talk about our experiences and to help others. And that's so important.
Oh, that's so brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
It really is. Yeah. And the conversations have just been fantastic on the show. Mm. So two of the trials. I love them. The more disgusting, the better. And the pair of you are bonding. Tell us a little bit about those trials. How bad are they?
They're worse than you think. I ate a cow's eye and he ate a bull's penis.
What?
It was, and a huntsman. Yeah, I ate a penis, a bull's penis and a huntsman.
Yeah.
On dry fairy bread.
Oh, did it taste anything like a hot dog?
It took me about 40 minutes to eat and they cropped it in 3 minutes.
Yeah, it took us a very long time to eat those things and they crop it down to about 3 minutes and it's just like...
Awful.
We
bonded over cow's eyes.
We're hearing so hungry we'd eat anything.
I was just going to ask that because we're hearing an awful lot about the hunger pangs that everyone are getting in there. We talked to Joey yesterday and I'm thinking like, would I sooner not eat anything or eat what you had to eat, especially that pop of those eyeballs. Oh. I don't think I'll be able for it.
It was bad. It was so bad. But I've never looked at dirt like I would eat it before. And I was looking at dirt like I'd eat it all the time.
So those tucker trials then, is that just like a source of protein? Does it come to a point where you want to do one just so that you're eating something?
Well, Brooke drank cow urine.
Yeah.
And that came straight back up. So it was no protein going in.
I don't think Brooke kept anything down that day. So I don't know if that helped her. And we all came back into camp and we couldn't eat lunch because we felt so ill. We just didn't eat lunch.
I was on the long drop.
Okay.
We were all struggling to go to the toilet after that too.
Oh, jeepers.
Just a real quick one. David, how are you dealing with this new... attention that's on you, I guess, because you must be getting swamped now. I love you come across so genuine on the show, and it's obviously the relationship that you've built with everyone on the show, but how are you dealing with all the attention now?
It's insane. Like, I literally went to the gym the other day and got chased by a pack. I'm in my daggy workout clothes, like, this is crazy. This is what the celebs talked about in the jungle. And I was like, yeah, whatever.
We warned you.
They warned me. And I'm like,
You've always got to look good.
Yeah, you've always got to look good now. Bloody hell.
There you go.
We love watching the two of you together. What a beautiful friendship has come out of this. Well, who will be ejected tonight? I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here continues at 7:30 right here on 10 and 10 Play on Demand. Emily and David, not the David, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks, guys. You're awesome. Take care.